Good morning, students. Now, welcome to all of you for your online classes, sir. Now, today, once again, the physics, sir. In my last classes, sir, I completed the lesson force and pressure. And I sent, before 10 days only, I sent the notes of this lesson, force and pressure. And after 2-3 days, I sent the exercise notes also. So those who not wrote the notes, you please write the notes in the physics class work. Once again, I am saying you all have to make the 3 separate notebooks, sir, for physics, sir, chemistry and biology. Physics notes you write in the physics notebook, chemistry in chemistry and biology in biology notebook. All the 3 teachers are different. One teacher is not handling all the subjects. So all you have to write all the 3 subjects in the separate notebook. And only 100 pages notebook is enough for the portion. If any doubt is there, you can ask. And how much portion I completed in my class, sir, the question answers is from that portion. You don't worry about the textbook. Textbook is not available, that everyone knows. Even the teachers and parents also knows the textbooks are not available. If you get the textbook from the old students, it's okay, you can read out. Otherwise, all the topics, activity we completed in our class. And revision also completed. And those who ask the doubts, we clarify them. And exercise notes we send you in the form of PDF. So while getting the question paper, no one will shout it is not there. But once again, if you are not understanding today and tomorrow in my class, how much possible I will complete the notes on the board. Those who are having the textbook, you write the questions from the board. And those who are not having the textbook, I am writing the questions also on the board. So you copy it. First question in the lesson, force and pressure. Question number 1. If you will cooperate with me, I will write. I will be after 5 minutes time I will give you. After that, once again I will rub and write. So you can complete the notes in the class. And one more request, those who not got the classes, please you check the YouTube. You will get all the classes, sir. Even the bridge course classes also there. And you not got the notes by mistake or by misunderstanding of your WhatsApp number. If you are not getting the notes, you please ask to your friends, sir. They will send you. First question, give 2 examples each of situations. In which you push or pull to change the state of motion take up motion of objects. Once again, I am reading the question. Give 2 examples, sir, each of situations in which you push or pull to change the state of motion of objects. If you will read the question carefully, you will get the answer, sir. don't think it's very hard, and again we have to read it up. Here you have to write the two examples in which you can see the push or pull to change the state of motion. If the things are at rest, it will start to move. If the ball is there at the resting position, you push it, it will start to move. It is an example of pusher. If the lorries are there, if you will pull towards you, it will come towards you. That is the pull. So, examples on variety. Pushing or crawling. Suppose a ball is there in near you. If you are pushing, a trolley is there. If you are pushing, it will change its place. So, pushing a trolley. Second example, pulling. Opening a drawer of a table. Pull. To open the drawer of your table, you have to pull it. So, these are the two examples. Once again, try to understand the question. Two situations are in which you push or pull. Here, pushing a trolley. And pushing a ball is also possible. Again, any one examples you can write from your daily life. Now, question number two. Give two examples of situations in which applied force causes a change in shape of an object. Shape of an object. So once again I am reading the question. Give two examples, sir, of situation in which applied force causes a change in shape of an object. So what is the question? You know the answers very well. If you are applying the force on an object, it will change its shape. If you are remembering the lesson, 6-7 examples I given from your textbook. So answer is, if you are applying a force on a plastic ball, it can change the shape or not. The ball will break. It means the shape of the ball will change. Duff. In the kitchen, when mother is preparing the duff for chapati, when she is applying the force, the shape of the duff will change. When she is preparing the chapatis, when they are rolling the chapatis, the shape of that will enlarge. Means it is changed. So, one common example, rubber ball change the shape after applying the force. Example. Second example, in your home, so many examples I give. Second example, spring fixed to the bicycle seat. Spring fixed to a bicycle seat, change the shape. Change the shape by sitting on it. Earlier the seat was little bit raised. When you sit on, the spring is compressed. So we can say it is the change in shape. Spring balance. One more common example is spring balance. When you load it, little bit 1 kg, 2 kg load on the hook, then the spring balance reading will get the change. So any one example you can write from your daily life. Plastic scale, when you put the weight on it, the shape of the scale will get the change. 6-7 examples I give. Now third one, fill in the blanks. Question number 3. Fill in the blanks with the suitable words. Here, first one, to draw water from a well, we have to get the rope. So everyone knows when you are trying to fetch a pail of water from the well, you have to pull or push it. Pull. Pull the rope. So physics is the easiest subject, and all is the examples and question answers, fill in the blanks, all are related with your daily life. If you can think it properly, you can write the answers. Now, a charged body dash charged body. An uncharged body and uncharged body towards it. So when I was teaching the electrostatic force, I said take the two straw, one break it in, take one straw, break it into two pieces, one piece you rub with any silk cloth or woolen cloth, it will get the charge. When you will bring near an uncharged body, it will attract. So we will, a charged body attracts an uncharged body towards it. Third one, to move a loaded trolley, to move a loaded trolley, we have to dash it. To move a loaded trolley, the trolley is loaded and we have to move it. Means if you can push it or you can pull it. Depends upon the your size, where you want to go forward or backward. So both example push and pull, both are correct answer. So now I am rubbing the question number 1. The North Pole of a magnet dash the North Pole of another magnet. So I all have to know when the same poles are there, it will repel. When the opposite pole, there will be attraction. So the north pole of a magnet repels the north pole of another magnet. Okay. Now, question number 4. All have to copy nicely after completing the one question and answer. Please, you leave one line and then start the second question answers. Don't continue it. So, from where you are starting the question and answers, I don't know. When you are bringing for the correction, when we call you, if at that time you are writing like this, like a theory, I will say to write once again. It should be clear from where the question and answer, after leaving one line, you start the next one. Now, question number 4. Here is also a fill in the blank, but here what happens, the suitable words are given. You have to select the appropriate word which is more suitable to that blank and then you have to write. So, just I am putting the habit. Putting the heading, filling the blanks. Filling the blanks with suitable words. In the question number 3, words are not given, you have to write. But in the fourth type question, here the few words are given, you have to select from them and you have to complete the sentence. Here, first one. To stretch the boat, words I'm not writing because I will explain fill in the blanks and which is the suitable words I will write. To stretch the bow, the archer applies a force that causes a change in its dash. Okay. So in childhood when you are playing with the bow and arrow, then when you are pulling the bow and putting the arrow in proper place, then which force you are applying? To stretch the bow. The stretch the bow, the archer applies a force that causes a change in its also understand that one as well. Shape will get the change. Then, second one. The force applied by the archer to stretch the bow is an example of force. That is there. So, which force you are using for stretch the bow? It is the muscular force, because you are doing that with the help of muscles. So, here is the muscular force. Now, you can see it properly. So, the type of force responsible for a change in the state of motion of the arrow is an example of a contact force, because when both are in the contact, then only it will stretch. The type of force responsible for a change in the state of motion of the arrow is an example of contact force. If the bow and arrow are kept separately, we cannot stretch. When you put the arrow at the proper place and stretch the bow, it is possible when both are in contact. So, it is an example of contact force. Fourth one. While the arrow moves towards the roots, towards its target, the forces acting on it due to description of A. Description of A. So here both are given to. So don't get confused, the question is wrong. Here only, once again I am reading you, try to understand. When the arrow moves towards its target, when you release the arrow from the bow, then the force acting on it are due to gravity. Because all of you know that earth is pulling each and everything towards it. So it is gravity. And that due to, well, friction. When the arrow and bow both are in contact, then due to the friction it moves up forward. So friction force of the air. So this is about your fill in the blanks. So I'll have to write in the physics class. Now fifth question. Now fifth question is very interesting. Here is the some activity which is related to your daily life. Here you have to write, when you are applying the force on an object, what are the changes you are observing on an object? Very easy, very simple and very interesting. If you are applying the force on the lemon, then what you will get? The shape of the lemon will get changed and you will get the lemon extract. If you are applying the force on the toothpaste tube, when you are going for the brushing in the morning, you are applying the force, then what happens? Paste will come out and the shape of the tube will get a change. So this is like this. The fifth question. So I am writing the question. Here the A, B, C, D, 4 are there. I will write one and answer. So, in the following situations, two situations are given. So, question you write. In the following situation, identify the agent exerting the force and the object on which it acts. Then state the effect of the force in each case. Now, once again, repeating the question. In the following situations, few situations are given in the question. There you have to find out or identify the agent exerting the force. Agent means who is exerting the force on that object, and then and the objects on which it acts, on which you are applying the force, and then state the effect. After applying the force, what are the effects you are observing on the object. So this is the three parts of a question. Now I will write the question number one and then its answer. There are the four situations are given. First one, A. As we can say, A. Squeezing the piece of lemon squeezing a piece of lemon between the fingers to extract its juice. So here answer is now all of you are familiar with the word lemon. Now it is easily available in each home. When you want to get the lemon juice, what you are doing, you will squeeze the lemon, means you are applying the force with your hands, so that is muscular force. And what is the result of applying the force? You will get the lemon juice. So answer you write, in squeezing the piece of lemon, force responsible is force is muscular force. Because you are applying with your muscles, then which changes the shape of lemon and object on which it acts, injects on the lemon, and state the effect of the force in each case, which changes the shape of the lemon and the agent exerting the force is fingers. So I think all of you understand. Identify the agent exerting the force. The agent exerting the force is fingers. And object on which it acts, it acts on the lemon. And if the result they are asking, you are getting the lemon juice. You can write in your own words also. If you will understand, you can write in your own way. First you can write, the agent exerting the force is the muscles, the muscular force. Then on which object, on which it acts, it is on the lemon. What is the result after applying the force? This is that you will get the lemon juice. Now, second one. B. Taking out waste from a toothpaste tube. Again, here the same thing. When you are taking the toothpaste, you will apply the force by the hands. Paste will come out, the shape of the tube will get the change. Taking out from the paste from a tube. Changes the shape of a tube. Changes the shape of a tube. and the agent exerting the force is fingers. By fingers only you are doing. Fingers. So that is for today's notes. Only A and B are given, C and D are remaining, then tomorrow I will continue. You are not having the textbook, so that I have to write the questions and answers are, so it is taking time. So don't worry, tomorrow I will try my best to complete the notes. But again I am saying, I send the notes before 10 days. So those who wrote the notes, and if any doubt is there, because now next time I will not get your class. So any doubt is there, you just inform me. I will clear your doubts in my class and I will continue the notes. So thanks to all of you and all the best for your study. If you are not understanding the writing, because this is the first class, so try to understand. And if any doubt is there, you just send me the message. I will clear your doubts and I will continue the next. Thanks to all of you and have a nice day.